Well, for some students and parents, math is a nightmare, one faced every day. But it doesn't have to be that way. Joining us now is Larry Martinek. He's the founder of something called Mathanasium. Yeah, good to have you on the show.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
First off, what is Mathanasium, Larry?
Well, Mathanasium is a place where kids come to really learn math. We have a program where we teach kids how to understand math rather than just memorize it.
Well, and that's something we were chatting about just moments ago, the fact that we're taught as students to memorize everything.
Right.
But you want to get children thinking about it so they don't have to, I guess, think about it in a sense.
In a sense?
Yeah.
Let me give you a quick problem.
Sure.
Most people, if they saw this problem, 99 plus 99 plus 99, would want to write it this way and add it up.
Okay, right.
But tell me, what's 99 plus 99 plus 99?
I'm going to have to... Give me a second here, Larry. I was told there wouldn't be math.
They lied to you.
Yeah.
So what's 100 plus 100 plus 100?
Sure, that's 300.
Now, how much extra did you add?
I see what you're getting at, yes.
And how much extra?
To get this now, I would take 3 away.
Take 3 away, and
sure.
So the answer is?
Then it would be 297.
297.
Sure.
No, and notice, no writing.
No writing.
And you're thinking it through, you're using principles.
Because you're exactly right. I'm sitting there trying to go, okay, that'd be 100%.
Right.
And I'm doing it the old-fashioned way.
Exactly.
Right.
Rather than, and this is what we teach kids to do at Mathanasium. In fact, what we do is when students come to us, we do an individual diagnostic.
Right.
And from that, we figure out exactly what they know and what they don't know. And typically what they don't know is how to think math.
Sure.
As much as use the algorithms, that is the procedures that are drilled into us.
The other big thing that's part of Mathanasium you were telling me is half numbers, right?
Well, half is being the first fraction. If you have a whole pizza,
right.
Of course you have a whole pizza. If you cut it into two equal pieces, you have half.
Sure.
Well, after that, it becomes a little more complicated. And when kids have trouble with math, what's one of the big things they have trouble with? Fractions. So we teach the fraction half. And about 100 different manifestations, so the kids understand how fractions work.
Sure.
So then we extend it out to quarter, because what's half of a half? Oh, that's a quarter.
Right.
What's half of a quarter? An eighth.
Now, my wife does that. She's a teacher.
Uh-huh.
And she does that with our children who are 4 and 6, both girls.
Great ages for learning this kind of material.
Right, and she'll do that with our older daughter. She'll do the fractions part of it to get her thinking that way with, like, marshmallows they're going to put
And they're
in.
Not writing that down, are they?
No, they're doing it all in their head.
They're doing it all in their head.
That's right, and she's doing it visually, too, so that they can have something tangible like marshmallows they're putting in their hot chocolate.
Right. In fact, one of the big thrusts in our program is to get kids to visualize math. So
sure.
I'm so glad you put it that way.
Give us another problem here, something that... For children who are struggling with math, a way you would help them or parents to get them to do
that? Okay, we'll start with an easy question. How much is half of 6?
Okay, that's 3, of course.
That's 3, of course.
Sure.
Now, why is that true, though? It's because 3 plus 3 is 6.
Sure.
Now, let's change that problem just slightly and make it half of 5.
Hmm.
Now, most programs would have you wait until you're in 4th grade or 5th grade to have you learn to do that after you've learned how to divide on paper.
Sure.
And some kids say there's no half of 5.
That's for sure.
Okay, but think about this. What if I tell you that I have 5 cookies,
mm-hmm.
and I say you can have half and I can have half. I'll take those 2.
Yep.
You can have those 2. What do we do with that last one?
Break in the middle.
Split it down
there
the middle.
Yep.
So you get 2 whole ones and a half. Each of us do. Oh, so half. You can do half of odd numbers. It's just the answer is not a whole number.
Very good.
So when we show that to kids, all of a sudden they go, wow. And then what happens is they want more.
Absolutely.
Because when you're successful, nothing begats success like success.
Exactly. And then it becomes so simple. And then again,
notice again, we're not using procedural things. What we're using is thinking. And then literally visualizing, because kids can see cookies.
That's right.
That makes a lot of sense to them.
Absolutely. Thanks for showing us this. That's great stuff. Very good stuff. And that's also a good point that we need to bake more cookies in the Butler home. Remember that, honey. Chocolate chip. Larry Martinek from Mathanasium, thanks for being with us. You're taking this throughout the country, is that part?
Well, currently I'll be doing 3 lectures here in the Twin Cities, one at 3 of our centers. And at www.mathanasium.com, you can find the locations of those.
Okay.
And I'll be here tonight and Wednesday and Thursday night.
Great.
And indeed, over time, we'll be taking around the country. We have, in fact, we have Mathanasiums in 7 countries as well.
Very good. Making adding up fun. Thanks so much, Larry.
Thank you
to have you on the show.
Even if you were a whiz in school, deciphering your kids' math homework can be a real challenge. There are ways parents can put an end to the nightly struggles and help their kids excel in the classroom. Larry Martinek, a nationally known math educator and founder of the Mathnasium Learning Centers, joins us this morning with more. Larry, thank you so much for getting up early and coming in.
My pleasure.
Around my house, I am the parent the kids don't want to have when it comes to their math homework.
Uh-huh.
I just never came real easy to me then, and it doesn't come easy to me now. And you fight this vague feeling of, I remember this, but you don't remember this.
Right.
So I'm happy you're here personally. If parents are like me and they're in that sort of a situation, what do you offer through Mathnasium that would help them?
Well, we offer a program that individualizes to the needs of the student.
Okay.
And we take the burden off of the parent by having the students come to our centers two, three, four times a week for off of one low price, so that the burden is shifted from you, who is uncomfortable with math, to us, who are trained to do the work.
So the student's coming to you a couple times a week?
Students could come to us literally every day.
Oh, okay.
For the way that we're set up.
Depending upon their needs?
Depending on their needs and their wants.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of kids come to us, they think they're only going to come once or twice a week, and all of a sudden they discover, hey, I can really do this stuff. And their attitude toward math changes, and then they want to come. And after that, then the world is a very changed place, both for the kid, the family, and their schoolwork.
Well, let's talk about the parents, the tips for the parents. And we're going to go through some items, and the first one you have is mental math. Explain that one.
Well, mental math. Let me ask you a real quick question. What's 99 plus 99 plus 99?
Oh, you threw in the third one, so I don't know. It's
well,
a quick answer.
Okay, well, what's 100 plus 100 plus 100?
300.
Okay, now how much extra did you add?
Three.
So what's the answer?
297.
Thank you. Did you have to write that down?
I didn't.
That's mental math right there. And starting from things like that, we can take you anywhere you want to go.
Okay. We have less than 30 seconds left, so I want to the other topics, and I'm going to just go through them. Why math is not a four-letter word, the importance of half and number sense, and I'm getting that they're all like mental math in the sense that you've got strategies that play off of all these to help a kid break it down and make it easier.
There you go. Well said.
Well, we're going to talk about some seminars that are coming up, and my last point I'd like to ask you about, though, is what they learn and then they take home. As a parent, are you able to help them with that, or do they not need your help at that point?
Well, the work we do at the centers, all the work stays there, because most kids have plenty of homework and plenty of other activities to take care of their time. So kids do the work at the centers, and then they go home, and then when they go to do their homework, they find, hey, I can do this.
Larry Martinek, thanks so much for coming in this morning.
Great.
You even taught me something. That's not easy to do.
Very cool.
There are three parent seminars scheduled for this week at Mathnasium locations in Savage, Lakeville, and Maple Grove. For the exact times and more information, call 952-952-237-6147. We've also posted this information and created a link on our website. Just go to care11.com and click on Sunrise.